In a previous video, I explained how IP addresses are used to allow your devices to communicate with each other and with the internet. In today's episode, we're going to take things one step further. The reason for this is because IP addresses are not as straightforward as they might first seem. The reason for this is because there are two different types. There are public IP addresses and private IP addresses. So why do we have private and public IP addresses in the first place? Well, initially, we only had public IP addresses. The first scheme or protocol that was developed was called Internet Protocol Version 4 IP addresses, or IPv4. And this protocol allowed for 4.3 billion IP addresses to be assigned to devices. The trouble with this, of course, was that as more devices were being connected to the internet, it was seen that eventually we would run out of IP addresses. So they needed to come up with a way to conserve or make these IPv4 public IP addresses last longer. And developing these private IP addresses, that was a way to do that. So what's the difference between private and public IP addresses? Well, let's dive into it. We'll start with private IP addresses. And the most important thing you need to keep in mind when it comes to private IP addresses is the fact that these private IP addresses are not accessible from the public internet. These IP addresses are used in, for example, your home Wi-Fi network or office buildings, and it allows these devices to communicate with each other. They can still access the internet, as you'll see in an example that I detail later, but just keep in mind that these private IP addresses, you can't access them from the public internet. It's not like a website, which uses a public IP address, which we'll talk about shortly. The way to identify an IP address is to actually look at its IP address itself. The way that the IP address is structured will tell you if it's private or public. For example, there are three basic ranges here that I'm showing. These are the private IP address ranges. So any IP addresses in these ranges, those are private. And I guarantee for most of you, what you're using in your home network, most of your devices follow the 192.168.0.x.1.2.3. That is the format that most home networks follow. Because these IP addresses are not accessible from the public internet, that's why you can have the same IP addresses used in each home network. For example, I bet if you go and you look up the IP address of your router, for most people, that IP address will be 192.168.0.1. And if you'll notice, that falls within the private IP address range, and that's why it can be used in each home network. If 192.168.0.1 was a public IP address, it would only be able to be used once by one device. Not every router in every home network would be able to use it. The vast majority of the time, your devices, such as your smart TV, your laptop, your mobile phone, these devices will be automatically assigned IP addresses from your router. Your router will determine what your device's IP addresses are. Alternatively, you can statically assign or choose a private IP address that your device is assigned. And that's something, if you're interested in, I've detailed in another video. But just keep in mind that most of the time, when your devices connect to your home network, your router will automatically assign it an IP address. To prove this out, here is the IP address of my laptop. As you can see, it's been assigned this IP address from my router. It's 192.168.0.50. And if you'll recall, this falls within the private IP address range because that's what your router assigns to your devices in your home network. All right, now that we have a good handle on private IP addresses, let's cover public IP addresses. The most important thing to keep in mind when we're talking about public IP addresses is that public IP addresses, they can be accessed by any device that has a connection to the internet. The other important thing to keep in mind is that these public IP addresses, they can only be used once. So for example, if a public IP address is assigned to a website, there will be no other online resource or no other website that has that same public IP address. These public IP addresses, they're assigned by your internet service provider whenever you set up your internet plan. So once you pay for that monthly plan, your home will receive one public IP address that it can use to access the internet. If you are registering or creating a website, your domain registrar will assign you that public IP address, so that way your website can be accessed by anyone with an internet connection. When it comes to identifying public IP addresses, you need to do the same thing as we did for private IP addresses. We need to look at the format of that IP address. And obviously, anything that is a public IP address is anything that's not within the ranges of those three ranges of private IP addresses. To get a little bit more specific about this, there are three different classes and three different ranges of public IP addresses that are used for things like websites, for example. There are additional classes of public IP addresses, but these are used for other purposes and they're outside of the scope of today's discussion, so we'll table those for now. So how are private and public IP addresses used together? In order to illustrate this, let's take a look at an example. All right, so here we are. Here's an example of a home network. And here on the left-hand side, here are your private IP addresses. So basically what happens, as we talked about, any devices in your home Wi-Fi network, they will automatically be assigned these IP addresses from your router. Your router will have that standard 192.168.0.1 IP address. For most people, not for everybody. But what's important to understand is this whole left side of the diagram is private IP addresses. Conversely, when you sign up for an internet plan with your internet service provider, your home will receive one public IP address. So if you look at this IP address here, it's just an example, but basically what this means is all of the devices in your home share this one public IP address. We're using the example of CNN.com here, which also has a public IP address. Say we want to visit this website at 151.1.1.3.5. That's CNN.com's public IP address. What happens is in this laptop, in the internet browser, you type in CNN.com. That request gets sent from this private IP address to this other private IP address of your router at 192.168.0.1. Your router then takes that request and then uses the public IP address that's been assigned to the router to access that CNN.com website at this IP address. So CNN.com will return that IP address back to the public IP address of your router. Your router then moves it over to the other side of the line here, and from its private IP address, it sends that website back to the device that requested it, this laptop at the .3 private IP address. So essentially what's happening here, your router has two IP addresses, one private, one public, and that's what allows your devices in your home network that have private IP addresses to access public resources at public IP addresses. This technology is called network address translation. We'll get into that in a separate video. We can get into the details about that. So let's say I had 100 devices on my home network. All of these devices can share that one public IP address to access the internet. Whereas if we didn't have private and public IP addresses, all of these 100 devices on my home network would need public IP addresses. And you'd see very quickly those 4.3 billion IP addresses that are made available by public IPv4 addresses, we'll run out of those within a day. And we'd really get into problems, and that's why we have private IP addresses in the first place. I should also mention here that this is not the only technology advancement when it comes to IP addresses. There's been a whole new format of IP addresses called IPv6, Internet Protocol Version 6 IP addresses. We'll eventually need to use that because even with this network address translation and the development of private and public IPv4 addresses, it soon won't be enough. We'll still run out of these public IPv4 addresses. That's why IPv6 was developed. Again, a topic for another time, but it's important to keep in mind that you have nothing to worry about once we run out of these public IPv4 addresses. I'd love to see in the comments section if you learned anything from today's episode, or if there are additional things when it comes to your home network technology that you would like to learn about. As always, thanks for checking out this episode from Network from Home, and we'll catch you on the next one.